Okay, so for problem 3, we have the setup, and the first thing we want to make note of is that since the coefficient of friction on box B is smaller than that of box A, then he's gonna, or if the box is gonna try to move faster than box A, which is gonna make it push it down. So the two boxes are gonna stay together at any point in time. So we can say then that the acceleration A is just equal to an acceleration of A and the acceleration of B. They're both moving equally. Knowing that, let's jump now to the free body diagrams. It's important to remember that usually when we have inclined planes, it's convenient to call our x-axis parallel to our plane, the incline, so that our gravity ends up coming this way with an angle of 20 degrees here. This is gravity of A. Then we have the force of friction, the normal force, and the force that V is applying on A, pushing it down. Then we move to B, and we have a very similar scenario, with the difference that now the force that's pushing A down is also restricting V to go down further because of Newton's law of first law. The to every action, there's an equal and opposite reaction. So we have this for B. So now we want to start doing sum of forces in X because that's where our boxes are moving for A. And in this case, we only have F, which we don't know anything about, plus the horizontal component of gravity, and minus the force of friction in A. This is all equal to mass A times the acceleration of the system, and if we expand, we'll be getting F plus ma times g, solving for g, sine of 20 degrees, minus, we know that if a is equal to na plus mu a, which is equal to 0.2 because of na, of mu a, times the normal force. And the normal force is equal to the vertical component of gravity, so it's gonna be ma g cosine of 20 degrees. So I'm gonna get rid of it here. And I'm gonna write it in our equation here. So we have ma g mu a times the cosine of 20 degrees. We're gonna do the same for V. right? So now that we have these two equations, we have a system of two equations and two unknowns. And you see that these equalities only have two variables for which the values we don't know anything about yet. And those are A and F. They're both presently. So I would do substitution to solve for A, and then we'll jump into kinematics to solve for the time. We can solve it pretty easily for F over in the first equation to be equal to ma. I'm gonna do it this way so that it's easier to handle later on. We're gonna have minus No, I'm gonna solve substitute that in the other equation so that we get BG sine 20 I'm gonna be factoring right here. This MB shows up, MBG shows up in both terms. G, no. Just sine 20 minus mu v cosine 20 minus what we have here. Once we have that, we only have one equation with A as a variable. So this equals that. And from there, we can add MA times the acceleration on both sides and get MB plus MA times the acceleration is equal to all our other terms. It's convenient for when you solve for this to put G here. We're gonna get that exact thing divided by the sum of the masses. And it's gonna be equal just to 1.82 meters per second squared. After that, We're gonna go to kinematics, and we're gonna use the x final equals x initial plus. Our initial position is 0. Our initial velocity is also 0, so this term is 0. And we're left only with this equality, and we know that the final distance is 2 meters. So t is the square root of 4 meters over a, and that's equal to 1.5 seconds.